फ्रेंड्स, गुड मॉर्निंग, वेलकम टू माय चैनल बालू मास्टर। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस टारगेट कॉमेट के 2020 पार्ट 11। टुडेज टॉपिक वी विल डिस्कस इनवर्स ट्रिग्नोमेट्री फंक्शंस। इनवर्स ट्रिग्नोमेट्रिक फंक्शंस चैप्टर इज वेरी इजी चैप्टर, कंपलसरी वन क्वेश्चन फ्रेंड्स। दैट्स व्हाट आई एम सेलेक्टिंग दिस चैप्टर। इन द नेक्स्ट सेशन फ्रेंड्स, आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस ट्रिग्नोमेट्री चैप्टर। इन ट्रिग्नोमेट्री दे आर गोइंग टू आस्क मिनिमम 3 क्वेश्चंस एवरी ईयर फ्रेंड्स। सो लेट अस स्टार्ट टुडेज सेशन फ्रेंड्स। First question, sine of 2 cos inverse of root 5 by 3. 2 years given, friends, the similar kind of approached questions. That's what, so previous examination question paper questions are very, very important. The same kind of model also may repeats. That's what, look at first question, friends. So whenever this kind of questions are given, very simple logic, friends, let it be called this part as alpha. If you call this as alpha, this is sine 2 alpha. You know very well sine 2 alpha formula, 2 sine alpha cos alpha. So I want to call that as alpha. Alpha is equals to cos inverse of root 5 by 3, which implies cos alpha can be written as root 5 by 3. Generally, we are going to apply both sides cos, then cos alpha equal to cos of cos inverse x. But we are going to call usually cos inverse and this side cos alpha equal to root 5 by 3 for our convenience. So now, what you are going to do means, very simple logic, friends, sine 2 alpha is there. Sine 2 alpha means the formula is 2 sine alpha cos alpha. Now from this cos alpha is ready. So you want sine alpha, then enough the sum. So sine alpha you want means, let us consider right angle triangle alpha. Cos means adjacent side hypotenuse. Then you are going to find out opposite side. Very, very simple. Opposite side is nothing but square root of hypotenuse side square. That's what, 3 square 9 minus side square root 5 whole square 5. 9 minus 5, that is what, 4 under root, that is what, 2. So sine alpha is nothing but from this information very clearly 2 by 3. Then finish the sum, friends. 2 times of sine alpha 2 by 3 cos alpha root 5 by 3. That's what you are getting the answer. No cancellations here. 2 into 2, 4. 4 root 5 by 9. That is your answer, friends. 4 root 5 by 9. Fourth option is correct answer, friends. Coming to next question. Similar kind of question only given, friends. Now the term is sine inverse. Let it be called this value as alpha. So what you are going to do? Sine alpha. Alpha is equals to, this means sine alpha is equals to what? Root 63 by root 65. What is your requirement? Now here cos alpha is your requirement. This is alpha. Let it be called this is root 63. This is root 65. You are going to evaluate, this means square root of hypotenuse side square. That's what, root 65 whole square 65 minus side square root 63 whole square 63. That's what, 65 minus 63 2 under root. That is what, root 2. From this cos alpha means you are going to write root 2 by root 65. Very, very clear. Sine 2 alpha here also. Sine 2 alpha can be written as 2 sine alpha cos alpha. That is nothing but 2 times of sine alpha, nothing but root 63 by root 65 into cos alpha, nothing but root 2 by root 65. This is equals to, no cancellations. So 2 into root 63 into root 2 whole by root 65 to root 65 is nothing but 65. Which option correct? Denominator 65 answer correct. Of course, all options given 65 only. And whereas numerator not given two different roots. That's what, just to multiply these two, root over 63 into 2 is nothing but 126. 2 root 126 by 65. That's what first option is correct answer. Coming to third question, friends, tan inverse x plus 2 cot inverse 6 equals 2 pi by 3. So how to do this sum means, you know very well one result, tan inverse x plus cot inverse x is equals to pi by 2. So by using that known result, we are going to evaluate that sum, friends. So very simple, this one I am going to write tan inverse x plus 2 cot inverse x, I am going to write cot inverse x plus cot inverse x is equals to 2 pi by 3. Tan inverse x plus cot inverse x is equals to how much? Pi by 2. Pi by 2 plus cot inverse x is equals to 2 pi by 3. Then cot inverse x is equals to 2 pi by 3 minus pi by 2. Take LCM, 6 as LCM, 3 2s are 4 pi, 2 3s are 3 pi. That's what the result is, pi by 6. X is equals to cot pi by 6. answer is root 3, cot 30, root 3. So which option correct? Third option is correct. Sin inverse 3 by x plus sin inverse 4 by x is equals to pi by 2. Then what about the result? Very simple formation is there, friends. The shortcut formula is sin inverse of a by x plus sin inverse of b by x is equals to pi by 2, means x you want to find out, means then x is equals to square root of a square plus b square. This is the formula, friends. So if you apply this formula here, x is equals to square root of a square, that's what, 3 square plus 4 square, that is equals to root 25. That is what answer is 5. 5 is your answer. Yes, coming to question number 5. Sine inverse of x root 1 minus x minus root x into root 1 minus x square followed by options. If you observe this question, it is completely related to formula based question. If you know the formulas for sine inverse x plus sine inverse y, sine inverse x minus sine inverse y, you can able to attempt this kind of questions. Look at, friends, the formulas. Sine inverse x plus sine inverse y is equals to the formula sine inverse of x root 1 minus y square plus y root 1 minus x square. Similarly, you have to know sine inverse x minus sine inverse y formula. That is what sine inverse of x root 1 minus y square minus y root 1 minus x square. Maybe they can ask the question in terms of cos also. That's what you have to learn. Cos related formulas also. Cos inverse x plus cos inverse y is equals to cos inverse of xy minus root 1 minus x square into root 1 minus y square. So whenever the question it is given in terms of sine and cos, you don't need to convert into in terms of tan. So directly we are going to apply the shortcut formula. Similarly, minus given means this is what? Plus. If you observe, plus means plus combination, minus means minus combination. Xy combinations you are getting. Whereas cos, xy combination only, all roots one side and xy one side. And also plus means minus, minus means plus. So now here, which formula you are going to apply means, the formula it is given RHS to LHS. If you observe the following formulas, if you observe here, sine inverse of something like that, it is look like formation number 2. So why? Because in between negative sign is there. Now what is the formula for here? Sin inverse of x root 1 minus y square. But if you observe here, it is not of the form whole square. So whenever this is 1 minus x given, whenever that is not whole square formation, you only convert, friends, just minus root x whole square. That's it. Minus root x into, means that is what, y into root over 1 minus x square. Yes, it is given. Yes, friends, now it is of the form. What is the formation? This is equals to sin inverse x. X is what? X only. Minus sin inverse y. Y is this one. What is the value of y? Root x. Yes, friends, this is your answer. Sin inverse x minus sin inverse root x. Which option correct? Third option is correct answer, friends. Very, very easy if you know the form. Next question, friends. Cos inverse P plus cos inverse Q plus cos inverse R is equals to pi, then what about the remaining results? So for this question, cos inverse P plus cos inverse Q means you no need to apply this formula, friends. I want to introduce, it's a very, very good shortcut for to evaluate this kind of sums. So what you are going to do means whenever cos inverse P plus cos inverse Q plus cos inverse R is equals to pi given, pi means how much? 180 degrees. Pi means 180 degrees. 180 degrees you divide into 3 equal parts, friends. That's what you are going to write. 180 by 3. That's what each angle is 60 degrees. That's what I'm going to write means cos inverse P is equals to 60. Cos inverse Q is equals to 60 degrees. Similarly, cos inverse R also 60 degrees. I'm going to write 60 degrees, 60 degrees, 60 degrees. 60 plus 60 plus 60, you are getting 180. Now, whenever cos inverse P equals 60 means P is equals to cos 60. Cos 60 is equals to how much? 1 by 2. Similarly, cos Q, similarly cos R. 1 by 2 is equals to Q is equals to R. So, P value, Q value, R value, you are getting 1 by 2. That 1 by 2 substitute in the given question. So, what answer you are getting? That answer only your answer, friends. So, what is your question? P square plus Q square plus R square plus 2PQR. That is what? 1 by 2 whole square, 1 by 4. 1 by 2 whole square, 1 by 4. 1 by 2 whole square, 1 by 4. Plus 2 into plus 2 into P, 1 by 2 into 1 by 2 into 1 by 2, P, Q, R. If you simplify here, 2, 2 get cancelled. If you observe 1 by 4 plus 1 by 4 plus 1 by 4 plus 1 by 2 into 1 by 2, 1 by 4. So that's what if you take LCM, 4 by 4, that is what the answer is, 1. So very, very good approach, friends. Option 2, 1 is the correct answer. Coming to next question, friends, cos inverse x equal to alpha, 0 less than x less than 1. And what about this result? This result also given. What about tan inverse 2x? It's a bit different model question, but it is easy. So by using like a substitution hint also given, by using that we are going to simplify. So what is the result given? Cos inverse x equal to alpha given, x is equals to cos alpha. That's what? Cos alpha is equals to, of course, x. So now given sin inverse of, if you want to evaluate this one, means sin inverse of 2 into x result you have cos alpha, you can able to substitute here 2 cos alpha root over 1 minus cos square alpha plus secant inverse of 1 by 2 cos square alpha minus 1 is equals to 2 pi by 3 given. This result given, just we are taken instead of x as cos alpha according to the given hint. So sin inverse of 2 cos alpha into 1 minus cos square alpha sin square alpha under root sin alpha plus secant inverse of 2 cos square alpha minus 1 is nothing but cos 2 alpha, 1 by cos 2 alpha nothing but secant 2 alpha, that is equals to 2 pi by 3. Now 2 sin alpha cos alpha means sin 2 alpha, sin inverse of sin 2 alpha 2 alpha plus secant inverse of secant 2 alpha, of course 2 alpha, that is equals to 2 pi by 3. Now 2 alpha plus 2 alpha is 4 alpha, 4 alpha is equals to 2 pi by 3, that's what 2 2's are cancelled, alpha is equals to pi by 6, 2 3's are 6. Now very simple question, friends, they're asking tan inverse of 2x. If you want to find out tan inverse of 2x, means you have to find out the value of x, that is the point which is important. Now x value you want means this alpha value you substitute somewhere, that's what you are going to write from here. X is equals to cos of alpha is what? Pi by 6. Cos pi by 6 means cos 30. Cos 30 is equals to root 3 by 2. So whenever x is root 3 by 2, so just you substitute that value here. Tan inverse 2x they're asking, that is what? Tan inverse of 2 into root 3 by 2. 2 to get cancelled. That is what? Tan inverse root 3. Tan which value root 3? Pi by 3. So what is your answer, friends? Pi by 3 is your answer. Coming to the next question, friends. Sin inverse of x by 5 plus cosecant inverse of 5 by 4 is equals to pi by 2. Then x equal to dash. Just they are checking whether you have formula knowledge or not. The formation is nothing but sin inverse is there, means the combination cos inverse required actually. Because sin inverse x plus cos inverse x is equals to pi by 2. So, if it is given cosecant inverse means by right angle triangle you can able to convert into cos inverse x. Right? So, what you are going to do? Cosecant inverse x, cosecant inverse of 5 by 4 is equals to, let it be called alpha. That is what? Cosecant alpha is equals to 5 by 4. By right angle triangle what we can able to write? Cosecant means first hypotenuse. Then, cosecant means that is what? Opposite side this is 4. So, obviously this is nothing but 3 according to triplets. Now, which result you want? This is sine combination means cos combination is required. From this cos alpha can be written as, you are going to write cos alpha is equals to 3 by 5. Of course, alpha is equals to what? Cos inverse of 3 by 5. Now, what happened here? Sine inverse of x by 5 plus cos inverse of cosecant inverse of 5 by 4 can be written as cos inverse of, this is nothing but alpha. Alpha proved as cos inverse of 3 by 5. That's what cos inverse of 3 by 5 is equals to pi by 2. Now, sin inverse theta plus cos inverse theta always is equals to pi by 2. That's what is the meaning? Angle should be same. Angles, whenever these two will be same, that time only the result satisfies as pi by 2. That's what x by 5 is equals to 3 by 5. 5, 5 get cancelled. Compulsory x should take the value as 3. That's what, which option correct? Third option is correct answer. So it's a very, very easy question and formula based question, friends. Yes, friends, in the next session I want to discuss trigonometry chapter, friends. It's a more weightage. They're going to ask every year minimum 3 questions. So let's wait for that session, friends. Thank you very much, friends. Thanks a lot.